course, for those who have not guessed it, that is the man sitting beside me.
Za one koji nisu prepoznali, to je gospodin koji sedi pored mene.
And he is also responsible for me being here tonight.
I on je također odgovoran što sam ja večeras ovdje.
So I'm very glad he was not a shy person.
Uistinu mi je drago što on nije stidljiva, sramežljiva osoba.
But there's more to this story than meets the eye.
Ali postoji više ovoj priči nego što se može očima prepoznati.
Here is a person who dared to speak a word, to bring a word to a stranger.
On je osoba koji se usudio razgovarati sa strancem, sa onim koga ne poznaje.
And in a very deep sense, he was a messenger.
I na dubok način bio je kurir, onaj koji daje poruku.
God was answering my doubt, my fear, my temptation.
Bog odgovara na moje strahove, na moje iskušenja.
And so I continue to write the story.
Stoga sam, pa sam nastavio pisati priču.
And my English language publisher in America was very, very happy with the manuscript.
I moj izdavač u Americi bio vrlo zahvalan i sretan zbog rukopisa.
It was published in the English language and began to sell very well.
Izdan je na engleskom jeziku i počeo se prodavati vrlo dobro.
But before that, I had also sent the manuscript to Matej Krajina because he was a friend.
A prije toga je rukopis također poslan Matej Krajini, jedan prijatelj.
And Matej, the founder of Treći dan, published it eventually.
I Matej je osnivač Trećeg dana, svejednom izdao.
But all of this seems to me a very great miracle.
Ali sve ovo se meni čini kao veliko čudo.
A very great mystery.
Jedna misterija, tajna.
And it has often prompted me to ask the question, what is really happening in culture? What is culture?
I često me navodilo na pitanje što se uistinu događa u kulturi.
In the modern age we have become more and more programmed to think culture is entertainment.
U modernom dobu svi smo neki način, svi postavljamo programirani da mislimo da je kultura u biti zabava.
Either high culture or low culture.
Bilo visoka kultura ili niska kultura.
We tend to think of it as something that we consume.
Na neki način postavljamo sklon da mislimo o tome da konzumiramo.
In a consumerist, materialist age, time of history, the danger is to think that everything we experience is something to be consumed.
U vremenu kojem živimo, u vremenu konzumerizma, materializma, postoji opasnost da sve što uzmemo na neki način moramo konzumirati. Je sve samo za konzumaciju.
This is to forget, but true culture is not production of objects. It is the production, the creation of living words.
Istinska kultura nije predmet, ona je stvaranje.
It's not about producing things.
Aha, to nije stvaranje, proizvodnja stvari.
It's more about communication.
A ona je više komunikacija čovjeka i čovjeka.
Soul to soul, heart to heart. Living words, not dead letters. Living words.
Znači živ svijet, živući svijet, ali ne mrtva slova.
And this is true of all culture, that speaks the truth in beautiful forms.
I to istina svim kulturama, da govori istinu, da se istina govori kroz lijepe oblike.
But it asks us, what really is a word?
Ali nas i pita, što je u istinu svijet?
Think of the word love.
Zamislite riječ ljubav.
Think of the word hate.
Pomislite na riječ mržnje.
Birth, death.
Na riječ rođenje, smrt.
Words are part of a language that is leading us somewhere.
Riječi su dio jezika koje nas negdje vode.
Where is language taking us?
Gdje nas to jezik vodi?
Are we simply imparting data to each other?
Jesmo li mi u stvari podaci jednim drugima, razvojni podaci jednim drugima, informacije?
If we think this is what language is, we have not yet learned But the human being is a miracle of God's creation.
Ako mislimo što je jezik, mi onda još nismo, ako mislimo ovako što je taj jezik, onda mi još nismo naučili da je čovjek stvar Božje stvorenje.
All true speaking is leading us forward to an eternal communion in paradise.
Samo prava komunikacija, pravi istinski govor nas vodi toj vječnoj komunikaciji, tom raju.
Why do all the races of mankind in all the stages of history tell stories?
Zašto sve rase tijekom cijelo čovječanstvo kroz povijest priča priča?
Why do we tell stories to each other?
Zašto se pričamo priče jednim drugima?
From a little child telling a very simple story to the great literature of the world.
Od malog djeteta koji govori jednostavne priče pa do velikih sjajnih književnika.
What is really happening here? Is it simply the transfer of information?
Što se uistinu događa? To samo prijenos informacija?
I don't think so. I think it is pointing to the true horizon of man's purpose and value.
Mislim da nije to, mislim da je to podizanje prema istinskoj vrijednosti čovjeka.
The infinite horizon.
Beskrajnim horizontima.
And also the interior horizon in each person.
Također i unutarnjim horizontima svakog čovjeka, svake osobe.
And in a sense, these two horizons are actually one horizon.
Na neki način, ta dva horizonta su jedan horizont.
A true story which is written beautifully, or a true film, or true music, will show us that these horizons are one horizon.
Istinita priča, bilo da je pričana kroz film ili kroz književnost, će nam pokazati da su to stvari, da su te dvije priče jedna priča.
I know a number of people who have lived under totalitarian regimes.
Znam bezbroj ljudi koji su živjeli i koji žive pod totalitarnim režimom.
Some fascists, most of the people I'm referring to under Marxist governments,
znači,
communist governments.
Fašizmu, marksizmu, u tim vladama.
And they all point to a common experience.
I oni svi naglašavaju jedno zajedničko iskustvo.
When a government suppresses the free speech or the free communication of a people,
kad vlade zabranjuju slobodu govora i slobodnu komunikaciju među ljudima,
what often happens, in fact always I would say, is that an underground culture is born.
Ono što se često događa se stvara kultura podzemlja.
And even in those nations where propaganda has dominated the formation of the young, the education of the young people.
I čak one vladama gdje je propaganda dominirala u oblikovanju mlađih generacija.
Where it has denied their eternal value.
Gdje su se nijekale vječne vrijednosti.
In culture there is a deep reservoir of the truth of the value of the human person. A deep reservoir.
U kulturi postoji duboki rezervoar stvar pravih vrijednosti.
A person may not even know the truth of his own history or of the truth of scripture.
Čovjek čak ne mora znati pravu vrijednost književnosti. Biblije, da.
He may know nothing about the things of God. He may have been told that he is only a cell in a collective, a social collective.
Možda mi je kazano da on samo jedna čelija u toj zajednici.
So he does not really know himself.
Stoga on biti ne poznaje samo sebe.
A person in such a society.
Čovjek u takvom društvu, takvom sustavu.
But let us say he is listening to a symphony concert.
Ali recimo da on sluša simfonijski koncert.
And something in the music without lyrics.
I nešto u glazbi, tekst glazbe.
Speaks to his soul and he suddenly finds that he is weeping.
Govori njegovoj duši, on se iznenada nađe kako plače.
He is suddenly feeling things within himself that he never felt before.
On iznenada stvari počne osjećati na ovaj način koji nikad prije nije osjećao.
I'm not speaking about emotion. I'm not speaking about the surface waves of emotion, but something very deep.
Ne govorim o osjećajima, površinskim osjećajima, o nečemu što je vrlo duboko.